Dad Award.
Yes, Dad.
Naked.
That stuff is all politics anyway.
Oh, yeah, someone went chink-a-chink in there. Oh, might be a key for that drawer. Locked drawer behind me. Oh, I love the sound of that. It sounds like treasure.
Sweet. A secret key.
Hehe.
Now to find the secret lock.
It's right there on the desk. But first, stuff. From Drew. Come on. Let me get to the top. I hate this part. Stop, stop, stop. Hey, Price. Thanks again for playing with Mikey. Haha, that was a good game. Good luck with whatever you're dealing with. Be safe. That's from all of us. Thanks. Mikey says, tell Chloe she can handle anything. Hope so. Alright, lock drawer last. Check out this file. Ooh, could it be on Damon?
Sheldon.
Sheldon Pike.
Why do I feel like I've heard that name before?
Yeah. It does sound familiar.
Sheldon.
Hmm.
Why do I feel like I've heard that name before?
I was hoping she'd say something more. Service award?
I guess getting your ass kissed comes with the DA territory.
Hmm. Service award presented to James Amber in appreciation of your integrity, honesty, and dedication to the fair and ethical administration of justice. Let's look at this file. This one's on Damon.
James sure keeps lots of files on people.
Gerald Scott. Who's that? Who's Gerald Scott? Computer?
Pro tip. When digging for secrets, try the DA's computer.
Okay.
Even if James is trying to protect Rachel from her mother, this seems like a pretty terrible way to act.
Learning that no one password protects their computer. From S. Gearhart at Gearhart.net. She has her own... Wait, Sarah has her own domain? Wait. Oh, it's screwed up. That should be to James R. Amber at ArcadiaDA.org.us. Since when does Oregon have its own sub... domain off of you. Oh, never mind. Subject enough. James, this is enough. When you told me at the park that you weren't going to let me be a part of Rachel's life, of course I was angry, but I understood your need to protect her. It's your prerogative as a parent. But sending that man to talk sense into me? Threaten me? You're losing the moral high ground here. What kind of way is that for a DA to act? What would the voters say? Ooh, hitting them hard. I have the right to meet my daughter, and the lawyer I spoke with agrees. But more importantly, Rachel has the right to know who her mother is, to know the truth. Do what you know is right, Sarah. Who did he send? She might be mistaken. Sending the man to talk sense into her and threaten her. Where do we... Right, he is a district attorney. I wasn't sure if he was just... Where do I get to put my, Yeah, I gotta put my mark. Arcadia Bay Police Department. Name, Damon Merrick. Case type, assault. In April 12, 2010, that's a month ago, Sergeant Alex Keller. So Damon is age 31. Yes, he's male. And 6'3", 180 pounds. Hair is brown, eyes brown. Or bro. He's white. Aggravated assault with a deadly weapon at 10:15 p.m. Date of offense, yes. Place of occurrence, Tumnus Lumber. After a verbal altercation with the victim, Merrick brandished a fire poker, hitting the victim several times about the head before fleeing the scene. Merrick's gloves were recovered and entered into evidence. A 911 call was received at 10:21 p.m. 10:21 p.m. 6 minutes later, right? And an officer arrived on scene at 10:38 p.m. with emergency medical team. The victim was taken to a hospital. A bystander who requested to remain anonymous named Damon Merrick as the assailant. I wonder who he attacked. He has a problem with hitting people with things, huh? What's this, a map
Arcadia
of Arcadia Bay?
Base, least oh. Wanted.
Least wanted? Can I see that closer? Not really. So crime report, this is all one thing, huh? Let's look in here. Ooh, what's inside? Evidence?
What do we have here?
What you got? It is evidence.
I should check the computer, or some of those files laying around.
Okay. Can I look at the files now? Now that I've seen that?
James has a file on Frank. I'd love to read this, but I've got to focus on finding Rachel's mom.
I'm hoping that now she has a reason to look at it, she'll actually look at it. Sorry, guys. I wish you can't skip the lines either. I wish I could.
Sheldon. Why do I feel like I've heard that name before?
I recognize Sheldon Pike's name as well. Just don't know. Remember.
I guess getting your ass kissed comes with the DA territory. James sure keeps lots of files on people.
Let's check the computer again.
Looks like a recent email from Rachel's mother to James. Even if James is trying to protect Rachel from her mother, this seems like a pretty terrible way to act.
Let's open this drawer then. Ooh, got some alcohol. Oh, we can graffiti that. Excellent. I was wondering where that would be.
More sherry.
Sherry, baby. I don't want to look at that. No, I want to look at that. I want to graffiti it, actually. Oh, come on. Let me do it. Thank you. He isn't going to wonder who the hell did this. Secret booze stash. Oh my god. They were getting along so well, too.
More sherry.
Ah. I was hoping she'd say something different. She usually does after she graffitis something. Alright, nothing left to do, I don't think, except to look at...
I need to dig through everything in this room.
I know. This is one more thing to look at.
I should check the computer or some of those files laying around.
Yeah, I can't. Well, I guess the computer is what we were looking for. Alright, let's open the drawer. First, let's look at the drawer.
Locked drawer inside locked office. Seems promising.
Mm-hmm. Betcha it is.
She's so Shadyville.
She's so careful the way she opened it. What's inside? It isn't ticking, is it? It's not someone's head?
James's stamp collection?
Something heavy inside. No? Nothing heavy inside? Oh, there's a phone. Oh, that's the phone that vibrated. Yep. Oh, we heard it. That's the secret bat phone to call her.
I have to know who James is talking to on the secret phone of his. It could be about Sarah.
Unknown, in case anyone finds it, they even can't track it to him. Damon? He blackmailed him, I bet. I'm told you can help me with my problem. So being me, I'm guessing, is James Amber. Some unknown person, I'm guessing, is Damon, for now anyway. Crossing the line, eh? Let's talk. We'll call tonight. Okay, so I guess at that point he called him. Because that was on April 21st in the afternoon. So now on April 27th, I found who you're looking for. 9:59 p.m. Sometime later, same night, call you in 15. So I'm guessing then he called him. This is very recent. May 4th. James goes, well, this isn't a charity. I'm going to need you to do what we talked about. From Damon, I'm guessing. James says, I can't. Sure you can, because I talked to your girl, and she has a big mouth. Damon, I'm guessing again, turns out she's not so easy. We're going to need to be more hands-on. Well, he might have called him after that or something, because there's some time. That was on the 4th. Now we're on the 8th, which is like yesterday or the day before. I'm not sure if it's the 10th now or what. So, yeah, May 8th, 11:45 p.m. Damon, I'm guessing. Turns out she's not so easy. We're going to need to be more hands-on. James says, don't hurt her. Relax. I've got my best guy on it. So now, May 9th, 12:22 p.m. How's your daughter? You know she attacked me first, right? You really should teach her to behave better. Of course, they're at the hospital, so he's not receiving this call, or this text, rather. Nothing? Guess you don't need this taken care of anymore. I was right. This is Damon. James and Damon. So yeah, then Sarah was right. He did send her, and that's what he wanted Damon to take care of. To get rid of Sarah. To what extent getting rid of, we don't know. Did he want her to kill her? Scare her away? Or what? Yeah, unknown. This is very thought-provoking, though, of course.
James is working with Damon Merrick?
Mm-hmm.
This is insane.
She's shaking.
What were they talking about? Is the girl Damon's talking about Sarah?
Seems so from the email.
Whatever is going on, I need to see if Damon knows where Sarah is. But how do I get him to tell me?
So we're going to text him. Maybe not threaten him. I don't think Damon responds well to threats. And I'm getting more trouble for the Amber family. So let me just ask, where is Sarah? Dot, dot, dot. So we're using names now? Relax, man. It's simple. Either you do what I want, or your little problem becomes a big problem. Now, did you take care of the evidence? Or not. So it is the 9th. The evidence. What evidence? So we're using names now. Yeah. They weren't using any names before. Not even their own.
Shit. What do I say?
Don't use names. What's the question? Do you take care of the evidence? I did. I know you're new at this, but here's how it works. You show me proof, I give you what you want. The evidence in the drawer. Give it to him? Give the evidence in the file cabinet to Damon, then?
Hope James actually has this evidence. Don't think Damon will tell me where Sarah is. Unless I send him a picture.
Can I look at this stuff yet? Who's this guy?
Sheldon.
Damn it.
Why do I feel like I've heard that name before?
I am trying to remember myself. Okay, I can't move. Okay. We're gonna take a picture of the evidence. Evidence.
Shit. Which of these is Damon talking about? I could just take a wild guess and see what he says. Or maybe there's some info on the case hanging around the office.
Bullet casing. What did he hit that guy with? I don't think it was any one of those things.
Sarah sent all these letters.
Oh, I never looked at this.
James never gave them to Rachel? That's so messed up.
Okay. Yeah, those were in with the phone. To my Rachel, my name is Sarah, and I am your biological mother. The first thing you should know about me is that giving you up was the worst mistake I ever made. I was struggling with something at the time, something that I have been battling with ever since. That battle has taken everything from me, more importantly you. But now I am in a place where I can be a part of your life. It is more than I deserve, I know, but I would love to try if you want to. Please take your time, and if you have anything to say or any questions, hearing from you would mean the world. I love you very much, and I hope to meet you soon. Love, Sarah. I wish we had dates. Like, how long ago was this? Dearest Rachel, I hope it's all right for me to write you again. I haven't heard from you yet, and that's okay. It really is. I feel like I have so much to catch up on, you know? I don't remember much of my life. It's a symptom of the choices I've made. So much is lost. Except you. I remember everything about you. The crinkle of your nose, the depths of your eyes, the knowing smile that somehow made it seem like you'd seen it all before. I can call it up whenever I want, as clear as a summer day. I was so afraid that I would be a terrible mother to you, that I would screw you up the way I screwed up so much of my life. Now, of course, I know, of course, that my fear was wrong. Far worse than being a bad mother is never knowing what kind of mother I would have been. I am sorry. If you can find the courage to forgive me, maybe we can start over. I want to. With all my might, I want to. Love, Sarah. Beautiful Rachel, I read somewhere, maybe a fortune cookie, that you can never step in the same river twice, because after it moves, it's not really the same river anymore. It's something new. Do you think that's true? It's the same river, it's just different water? I try to picture you reading these letters. I wonder what your reactions are, how I might seem to you, this mystery mother. I don't blame you for not writing back. You will write when you are ready. She's kind of naive, thinking that she ever got to read those letters. She just sent it to their house, right? Mailed it? Of course the parents are going to open it. I imagine your dad is still wary of all this. That's okay. James is protective of you, just as I would be. But he's also a kind and compassionate person. That was the problem, really. I wasn't cut out for him, or the life he wanted to give you. Given you. I knew it then, even when he didn't. I know we could never have the same relationship we should have had, but I hope we can have something new together. I hope it so much. All my love, Sarah.
The Sarah in this letter doesn't seem anything at all like the person James told us about last night.
Hmm. I wonder if he made any of it up, right? What's the full truth, right? So now she's writing to James. I understand your reluctance to let me speak with Rachel, but don't you think the decision should belong to her? Everything I have done over the past year has been to prove to you that I am ready to be in Rachel's life. I've gone through rehab, I am in recovery, and I am no longer in need of money or assistance. I know I can be a positive influence for her. I am coming to Arcadia Bay in the hopes that we can at least meet to discuss this. So you can see how much I've changed. If you have any feelings left for me at all, you will give me a fair chance to prove myself to you, and hopefully to Rachel, too. You were the love of my life once. Please don't take this away from me, Sarah. Oh, Costerman Shapiro Family Law, cease and desist. Dear Mr. Amber, I represent Sarah Gerhart, lawful mother of Rachel Amber and petitioner for partial custody of Rachel Amber, her lawful daughter. Wait, she just wanted to reach her, like get in touch with her. Now she wants partial custody? Please take notice that Oregon law requires current guardians of minors to respond in good faith to any and all lawful petitions by parents to reestablish contact with their children. On behalf of my client, I hereby demand that you cease and desist from unlawfully denying contact between Sarah Gerhart and Rachel Amber. Go, yeah. You are now considered to be on notice that continuing refusal will result in a petition for suit filed under Oregon Family Law Statute 42-4B, Tillamook County Family Services. This letter constitutes your final notice on this matter. Sincerely, Kevin G. Shapiro, LLC. Doesn't that mean Limited Liability Corporation? This is the name of the firm. Never mind.
So, this looks like Sarah stopped cashing the checks James sent her. Guess he forgot to mention that during his story last night.
Wow. April 25th, 2010. $3,000. Hmm. Wow, how about that? Oh. Can I look at this now? Probably not.
James has a file on Frank.
Could be helpful.
I'd love to read this, but I've got to focus on finding Rachel's mom.
I'm looking, yeah, for the crime report. Which one was that? A fire poker. Well, we don't have that in there. So we're gonna have to look at this stuff. This can't be the same knife. It's a different knife. But maybe he buys from the same, maybe he has a bunch of those knives identical. Seriously? I could just blindingly take a picture. Hold on. Gloves, wait a second. Can't help but think this is a clue to everything. Merrick's gloves were recovered and entered into evidence. Hell yeah. It's not a murder weapon, but it is evidence. That's what kind of threw me. I was just naturally looking for a weapon. Can I look at all this?
If TV has taught me anything, these babies will be swimming in DNA.
Yep. Same date, right? Victim is Eli Forbin, whoever the hell that is. Recovered by Officer Ernie Yates. That's a different officer than filed the report. I want to look at the other things, though. Just don't take a picture of it, whatever you do.
Did Damon really shoot someone? Guess I shouldn't be surprised.
22 casings. April 12th as well? Same?
Huh.
Yeah.
If TV has taught me anything, these babies will be swimming in DNA. Could this be the evidence? Damon and Knives seem like a solid bet.
They're all the same date and the same victim. So what the hell did he do? Shoot him? Then stab him? And then with gloves on, hit him with a poker knife? No. It's a poke. What the hell was it again? A poker thingy. A fire poker. So the poor guy was shot, stabbed, and then hit with a fire poker? There's something missing from that report. Alright, let's take a picture of the gloves. Max, eat your heart out. I'm waiting. What? That's evidence, right? Yeah, and now you bleeping destroy it. Why are you so bad at this? I'll get right on that. We have to destroy the gloves and then take a picture?
If I can figure out how.
Burn them?
How do I destroy a glove?
Yeah.
Maybe I can burn it somehow. Hope James doesn't really get Damon off the hook. That dude's gotta pay.
Burn glove. I don't suppose now we can look at these? Oh, it's not even showing up. We could use the sherry to help with it. Do we have a lighter? So we're helping him get away with it. Fire glove with me. Mm. So does the guy want a video? I'll take a video of it. Is that a wooden trash can? Yeah.
Better not touch that again.
That's right, it's disarmed. Got a sensor tamper, probably. You've taken care of it. Good. So, since you're destroying evidence, might as well tell me which of my guys was the snitch. Damon says. One of them was a snitch? No clue. Any leads on who it might be? Sorry, that's your job. Tell me who it is, or maybe you'd rather deal with the problem yourself? Huh.
Damn. I hope James has something here to tell me who Damon's informant is. So I need to find which of Damon's guys has been snitching.
Let me look at the folders.
I should search around the office to see if there's any info to help me out.
One of these guys, huh? Alright, we got... Got our own text. Don't screw up and answer Mom on the Damon phone. Alright, it's 3:19 p.m. Mom says, planning supper. What time do you think you'll be home? Don't wait for me. Sweetheart, we don't get enough family time as it is. Does Rachel want to join us? She's very welcome to. Yeah, she's a little, yeah, she's unavailable right now. Mom, I just can't make it tonight. Sorry. Chloe, is everything okay? Yeah, everything's fine. Okay, love you. Love you too. Alright. I'm guessing it's all here, but let me look around again. please let me look. Yes, I can investigate.
I've been learning a hell of a lot about Frank lately.
Yes, I want to learn more.
Okay. There's no way that Frank is snitching on Damon. But I love learning about his badass loitering charge.
Seriously? Suspect's name, Francis Bowers. Known alias is Frank, Frankie, Frankie B. Sounds dope. Date of birth was only in 81. He's a kid still. This takes place when? When does it take place? I forget what year this takes place. 6 feet, 1 inch, 190 pounds. Scars and tattoos, unknown. Well, you can't just search him. Detained May 23rd to May 25 of 06 by Arcadia Bay Police Department on suspicions of drug dealing, loitering. Drug dealing charges dropped due to insufficient evidence. Okay. So in 06, he's 25 at that point. It's 2010. He was born in 81?
Okay. There's no way that Frank is snitching on Damon. But I love learning about his badass loitering charge.
Alright, so he's 29 then. Pretty young. He looks older than that. Okay, so I can look at all this stuff now.
Guess I'm lucky James keeps so much info at home.
Hard copies nonetheless.
I agree to aid the courts on future cases. That could be seen as a little snitchy.
Oregon State Court. State of Oregon versus Gerald Scott, defendant. I, the defendant, plea as follows. Charge, illegal sale of stolen goods, guilty. I understand my rights and give them up of my own free will. I understand the judge is not bound by this agreement. I agreed to aid the courts on future cases related to my own. March 17th. Cool. Now can we finally find out how this guy is?
Feels a little weird having this guy's records at my fingertips.
But not weird with the others?
This is that freak from the mill. Wonder what Damon would think of his very cooperative comment.
Huh. Parole Supervision Services. This is on April 30th. Sheldon Pike. Were you arrested in the last month? No. Employment. Same. Verified income in the last month. $1,775. Company ACFC. Oh! He works for the fire company? Shift leader. I'm guessing FC Fire Company. Although, we've seen it before, ACFD, so I'm not sure. FC would be the same thing. Officer comments, has been very cooperative. No missed check-ins. Yeah. That just means he hasn't missed parole. Doesn't mean he's a snitch. It seems more likely to be this, Scott guy. Can I look at it from here? Just says file. Yeah, his name is Gerald Scott.
I agree to aid the courts on future cases.
Yeah.
That could be seen as a little snitchy.
Anything else with the computer? Oh, we can do investigate with the computer now.
Pro tip. When digging for secrets, try the DA. Oh, man. This guy's the snitch. He was so cool to me at the mill. Wonder if there's someone else I could pin it on instead.
Oh. Yeah, screw this guy. If you pin it on somebody else, that seems unlikely. Because you don't know these people. Damon knows these people. So if you say Gerald Scott and it's not him, he's gonna be like, what? You're talking out your ass. And then that's it. No deal, Sporto. So yeah, Rodney Sears, known alias as Thunder. He is 6 years older than Frank. 219, 1975, Palo Alto, California, 6 feet 6 inches. All these people are tall. 240 pounds, scars and tattoos inside left bicep. If the thunder don't get you, then the lightning will. There's a little thunder with a little lightning. American Samoan. Details. Detained by Arcadia Bay Police Department on suspicion of drug trafficking. Released after questioning by Officer Ernie Yates. Described as a highly cooperative source of information on local criminal activity. Well, it doesn't mean necessarily he snitched on him, but he looks the most likely. That other guy just checked off that he'd cooperate with court cases similar to his own. Doesn't mean that he did. So, yeah, I think it's most likely to be the Rodney Sears. Yeah, I don't care. I will turn in Rodney Sears, drop of a hat. She's thinking. What's going on? Or was saving? I think it was saving.
Arcadia Bay's least wanted.
Accuse.
Okay. If I'm going to accuse one of these guys, I'd better be sure I'm right.